What's happening, my beautiful people? My name is Dirty Mike, and today, my friends, I'm back into action, and I got another squad builder if you're looking for something a little more affordable, around that 100K mark that you can use in FUT Champions. We built it live on stream, but then I was a little bit burnt out of playing FIFA, so I put together the games. Everything's going to be in Division 1. We're in that 4-3-1-2, which is a formation I used last weekend, and I thought that it had a lot of potential, so figured it's time. Let's put together a cheaper option in this formation. It fits all the requirements. If you enjoy the content and you want to see my reward packs, drop a thumbs up because I'm going to put those together. And then also with my expensive team, you guys will be the decider. Maybe I'll put together a double upload. Happy Black Friday. I hope pack luck treats you well. And then in the comments down below, what kind of teams are you guys using this weekend? I'm always interested in if you're using two squads and what you've kind of put together, what makes sense. And the last thing that I'm going to mention before we get into the highlights, the clip breakdown, the squad, all of the above, please get involved. The previous video was a 200K subscriber special, and I'm dropping, I think it's 7 or 8 giveaways. I'm talking every social media platform, free, absolutely free. We're talking headsets, mice, keyboards. I've got a special gaming bag. We got FIFA points, controllers, you name it, all the above. Speaking of FIFA points and codes, if you guys do want to get involved, use Dirty as a cashback code at G2A. I'm going to leave the links down below in the description. Player instructions. And if you've been on the channel, a lot of these instructions, a lot of rinse, wash, and repeat, you don't see me change all that much, but I do want to make a statement. And this is going to be talking about the strikers. I like them to be very aggressive. In the 4-3-1-2, I want you to get in behind, to press my opponent, to be a nuisance. And something I've noticed is that stay central doesn't work well for me. Because this formation is so narrow, when I have them on stay central, they never make those outside runs. And sometimes I need a release, especially late in a game. If I'm going to stay in this formation, you're not trying to necessarily clock management, but you need somebody to make some runs that give you some width. And custom tactics, those can always be flipped around a little bit for me, but that's what I'm starting off with. I'd love to see what you guys are doing for your custom tactics, actually, if you want to drop that down below. All these matches are Division 1, as you would expect. We got to get some practice under our belt. Let's start with the defense, because I like to do a mini squad review. The good, the bad, the ugly, what I noticed, which players you can count on, who flowed, who didn't flow, what kind of rhythm do they have together as a team? Oh, and one disclaimer, in the final match that you're going to see in this video, there will be no Martial sighting. And what happened is after I played 2 games, one of my subscribers wanted a friendly. If you're on Discord, you guys know, I get down. I'll play some friendly. So I gave him a match, and the only reason you're not seeing on YouTube, I won the game, but I didn't notify him that this could be played on YouTube, so I felt like it would be wrong for me to put up that video. Maybe he didn't want to have a 1-0 loss on YouTube, so I didn't. But I got a red card with Martial, so the final game, you're not going to see any Martial. It'll be Remy, and before you guys get in the comments, like, hey, Mike, I never saw Remy in the squad builder. What are you doing right here? You think we're stupid? No, I don't think you're not up to par. That's what happened. I just decided to plug Remy in for the final match. But defensively, you've got a couple players that I really rate. With Smalling, and I would have preferred a Luke Shaw here, but I ended up going with AZP. He's not bad. Yeah, but is he worth 5,000-6,000 coins? Is he one of the best left backs in the game? No. He's not as good as an 84 rated player should perform. Joe Hart was good money. A lot of people have been co-signing Joe Hart this year, so that should not come to a major surprise. Manolis and Perez, it worked out fine. I felt like Perez and Smalling were the two standout or primetime performers when you're looking at the defenders. Where AZP was kind of iffy at times. And then Manolis, I had some issues with his positioning. I do have his in-form card, which I'm debating using for the weekend league, actually. That could be something interesting. It could be special. I've got the red joint, and those cards look very nice. And red joint, not a weed reference at all. Damn, did you see that big body work there from Marsh, y'all? I need to drop a shielding tutorial. Let me know in the comments, or drop a thumbs up if I need to drop a shielding tutorial. I think it's about that time. And in the midfield, we got Nainggolan, Fellaini, and I also went with Perea. I was talking to Rosemeyer, and he was telling me how much he rated Perea as one of those cheaper beasts. So I was like, all right, cool. I'll go back and use him. It's been a while. He was decent in the midfield. I like Nainggolan and Fellaini. I think they work well Maybe this is the Belgium connection. Spencer FC will be proud about that Belgium connect. Fellaini, I do want to let you guys know that he tends to float. As an individual, in terms of his talent, oh, it's a beautiful thing this year. I'm not sure if it's the afro that gives him his power or his strength, but the man cannot be big-bodied, and he's all over the place. And it can kind of be a double-edged sword because I do find him out of position quite often. He goes too far forward, and then he'll be back playing CDM, and kind of that's what you can expect. It's random positioning. If you're somebody who likes to have a lot of structure in your midfield, I don't know that he fits that heavy structured positioning feel. Unless you're going to pull him back every time manually, which, hey, that could work. But I do rate Fellaini as an individual. And then up top, we got a new type of triangle. We got the Vardy, Martial, and then the Wayne Rooney, who had an excellent game in the last United match where he scored a little chip shot. He had an assist to Juan Mata. Maybe time. He's not done yet. As there's Remy. Remember I told you Remy was in the last game? That's why I mentioned it right there. As we concede a penalty kick. A soft penalty kick at that. I love Martial, and I love Jamie Vardy this year. I actually rate Vardy over Daniel Sturridge, over a lot of strikers. People ask me constantly about Jamie Vardy because they do see that I'm using him in many different squads, and I think he's certified this year. He gives you good strength, good finishing, not a bad touch. He doesn't have the skill moves. I just believe in him. I can trust in Jamie Vardy. When in doubt, he's got my back. He's very explosive. And that's something that I always like to stress is when you have players that go from nothing to something very quickly, boy, that explosion is special. Same with positioning as Wayne Rooney taps it home. What do you expect? He's the main man. And I think Wayne in this FIFA installment is actually one of the best Rooneys we've seen in a long time. And I don't know if he's underappreciated, but I don't see him in that many squads. You can play him as a center mid, a cam. Maybe you could get away with a CDM. I don't think I'd recommend it. But people take for granted how physical he is and then also what he offers you in terms of being able to go the whole match. Man does not get tired. But if you enjoyed the content, make sure to drop a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're brand new. Remember, I'm going to drop my reward packs as well as a weekend league team, an additional weekend league team if you guys really support this video. But I'll have a lot more coming for you ASAP.